Welcome to our B band concert. Just wanted to take a moment to say this concert always impresses me because, as you know, your children have not been playing for very long, but they come together and they sound great. So I'm going to hand the mic over to Mr. Zednicki to get our show started.
Good evening, thanks for coming. Again, we are just a very group of beginners who have only been playing since roughly September. And when you do the math about, 40 minutes a week, once a week, it ends up being, 40 or some hours. So this is the result of about 40 hours worth of instruction. Doesn't seem like a lot, but I think you're going to be amazed at what these young ladies and gentlemen are going to do for you this evening. The first one that we have on the program for you is called Beethoven's Ninth, arranged by Paul Lavender. The Symphony No. 9 in D minor, opus 125, is also known as Beethoven's Ninth. It is the final complete symphony by Ludwig van Beethoven, composed between 1822 and 1824. It was the first performed in Vienna on May 7, 1824. One of the best-known works in common practice music, it is regarded by many critics and musicologists as one of Beethoven's greatest works and one of the supreme achievements in the history of Western music. In the 2010s, it stands as one of the most performed symphonies in the world. Our arrangement of Ode to Joy, which comes from the fourth movement, provides our students with experiences with this classical literature by only including reading of basic rhythms, quarter notes, half notes, and whole notes. Towards the middle of the piece, Paul wrote short features for each of the instrument families. So this is Beethoven's Ninth by Paul Lavender. And squawks that you heard back in September, right? Throughout the evening, just to kind of give, these young faces that are still developing muscles a little break, I like to feature self-selected students on solos. So I say, hey, if you want to play a solo, find something in your book, learn how to play it, and you can do it. So all these students that you're about to hear throughout the evening were all, again, volunteers. They worked on it themselves, and they got it all prepared. So the first one that we're going to hear from is Sydney on the trumpet, and she's going to play Hot Cross Buns.
Thank you.
Our next song, the Hay Song, was originally arranged, well, arranged for us a long time ago by a former music educator, Greg Antonowicz. And this comes from Rock and Roll, also known as the Hay Song, is a song that was released in 1972 as a single and on the album Glitter. The song is in two parts. Part one is a vocal track reflecting on the history of the genre, and part two is mostly instrumental piece. Both parts were popular in Britain, and the single went to number two on the British charts. In concert, they were both usually merged into one performance. It is here that in North America that part two became popularly associated with sports, as a number of professional teams adopted the song for use during games, primarily to signify scores and victories. It is often referred to as the Hay Song, as it is the only intelligible words in part two is the exclamation of the word hay, punctuating the end of several instrumental phrases. Our arrangement offers advanced syncopated rhythmic ideas in the winds, as well as a standard rock beat in the percussion section. Please help us out by shouting hey when we get to those parts. I bet you already know where they are. This is our arrangement of the Hay Song. Gives me an idea for a song for next year. All right. Our next song, entitled Shark Attack, it's an original composition written by Les Taylor. The shark attack, which is a generic term used to describe an attack on a human, every year over 70 attacks are reported, which aren't very many considering how much there's a lot of just fear surrounding the idea. As we take note of, it's found its way into horror fiction films such as the Jaws series. The tune Shark Attack plays with our imaginations as we dive deep into that. It starts out really slowly, reminding us of the theme from the movie Jaws. As the shark closes in for the attack, we become a little bit more intense with tempo and dynamics. So you're going to see and hear a tempo change, which needs to get faster. And all of a sudden, we lose sight of the shark, don't know what's going to happen next. Be sure to listen for the complex rhythm at the end of Shark Attack. This is by Les Taylor, Shark Attack. So I didn't want to give away that surprise, but at those moments of chaos, that in their music, it just says, play any note. So they're like, here, you're going to play, everyone choose a different note, and you're just going to play it. Yeah. So that was our effect of the attack. So up next, we have some solos here, when the Saints go marching in, as performed by John Paul on the flute. going to have a duo. This is going to be Mary Had a Little Lamb, performed by Kaylin on the clarinet and Cole on the saxophone. Latin rock is a term described a music subgenre consisting in melting traditional sounds and elements of Latin American and Caribbean folk with rock music. However, it is widely used in the English language media to refer to any kind of rock music featuring Spanish or Portuguese vocals. This fact led into a controversy about the scope of the terminology. Latin rock should not be confused with rock music from Latin America or rock en español. It's also closely related to the Latin alternative scene, a term often used to refer to the same phenomenon. BB Does Latin Rock offers our students the opportunity to learn about the use of eighth notes, accents, repeat signs, and traditional Latin percussion instruments. This is Nicholas Forte's arrangement of BB Does Latin Rock. Soloist will be Lynette on the flute. She is playing Doodle All Day. Following that will be David on the saxophone. He's playing "Oh, Susanna." Called "Slideways," written by Timothy Loest, and this is probably our most complicated song on the whole program. Along with learning the music, we talked about the poem that it was written on, and it was based on the story of the trombone who just felt like he did not fit in. He didn't have any flashy buttons or keys, and he just felt he was big and clunky, so he ended up going on a diet was the poem, and became way too weak to even make a toot. So his friend came along, the slide whistle, and said, "It's about who you are inside." So we had a little bit of a character discussion as we talk about how that could relate in our own lives. But the piece itself, it is, as I said, it's pretty humorous. You're going to listen to very fun sounds that come from the percussion section. But it features the trombone and the slide whistle. With both of them having the unique mechanism of these instruments, the slide. Loest makes use of this by writing in special effects called the Sandy. This arrangement also provides the opportunity for us to work on subtle dynamic changes between mezzo forte, mezzo piano, and forte. It also introduces the skill of the slur, articulating the first note but not the notes that follow it, as well as the separated style of the staccato marking. This is Slideways.
Thank you.
soloist for the evening will be Kira on the clarinet. She will be playing Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. Breakfast this Friday, May 31st. I had just sent out an email right before we came here today. So if you are able to sign up to bring any of the available slots for the food in kind of a potluck fashion, we will have it in our cafeteria on Friday at 8:15 in the morning. Also, if you have looked at the summer enrichment program packet that was maybe emailed out to you, I'm not sure how it was delivered to you, but available on our website on pdsd.org, there's a whole bunch of summer enrichment programs, and one of those is a band program for all students who are going into grades 5 through 9. So that would include these students up here. So if you're looking to give them something to do for 4 days at the end of June, please consider maybe signing your son or daughter for that. A bunch of thank yous that I'd like to offer to help make tonight possible. We have Dr. George Steinhoff, our superintendent, Mr. Eric Kaminka, our assistant superintendent, all of our board of school directors, our principal, Mrs. Sue Phillips, our general music teacher, Mrs. Denny, for everything that she does all the way from grades 1 through 5. So she lays out the groundwork for all of these students here with learning how to keep a steady beat and learning how to match pitch. The entire music department, for that matter, for all the help and support that they offer me and as I bounce off ideas with them. The Pendelco Facilities Department here was led by Mr. Farmer. So thank Mr. Farmer for having chairs set up for all these guys up here for you to sit. I also look forward to him cleaning up the stage after us. As well as our secretarial staff who do so much behind the work, but they always do whatever they can to help support our program. We have a videographer here tonight. Thank you for making sure that we get the support that we need. Families, friends, all of you who are here, and maybe some who might not have been able to be here. Everything that you do to help support these musicians, they can't do this without your love and support. And some of it being financial, time, cars, getting up early. Thank you for being an alarm clock for those 7 mornings that we had 8 o'clock. But all of that goes into putting together what these students have been working for all school year long. So last but not least, thank you to all the students who are on the stage for everything that they've done, being respectful, responsible, safe, coming down to lessons when they're supposed to, practicing their instruments when they had the chance, and just overall being great young boys and girls that just have always, they always shine up my band room every time that they're in. So many thank yous to go around. If I forgot someone, something, thank you. Didn't mean to leave you out, but so much goes on, and thank you for allowing this to happen, everyone who's here today, I guess. Okay. Our final song, tradition for us to end our portion of the concert, Let's Go Band. The melody to Let's Go Blue was written by Joe Carl with various dates given for its composition, including 1972, 75, and 76. Carl, who at the time of the song's composition was an undergraduate student at the University of Michigan and a tuba player in the Michigan Marching Band. improvised the melody as a timeout ditty for use during a hockey game at a Yost Ice Arena. The song went viral after it was played by the Michigan Marching Band during the national telecast of the 1976 Orange Bowl. Sheet music for the song was published in 1978, followed by an organ version in 1983. So our arrangement was actually put together by, again, former music teacher Greg Antonowicz. So I'd like to honor everything that he did to build up this program with Let's Go Band. Thank you for coming out. I hope to see you again next winter for these A Band Winter Concert next year. Thank you. By the then 35-year-old lawyer and amateur poet Francis Scott Key after witnessing the bombardment of Fort McHenry by British ships of the Royal Navy in Baltimore Harbor during the Battle of Baltimore and the War of 1812. Key was inspired by the large U.S. flag with 15 stars and stripes known as the Star-Spangled Banner flying triumphantly above the fort during the U.S. victory. Please rise for our arrangement of the Star-Spangled Banner. Thank you. Our first official tune of the program is entitled The Soaring Spirit, written by Rob Bryce. Described as jubilant and festive, The Soaring Spirit was inspired by the boundless energy of young musicians, the journey they take to create inspiring performances, and the enduring human spirit. The Soaring Spirit is loaded with many different musical concepts that we learned to perfect this year. Unexpected patterns of quarter notes and eighth notes, emphasize notes called accents, notes that sound separated because of dots on the page called staccatos, a wide range of dynamics from mezzo piano to fortissimo or medium quiet to very loud, overlapping melodic lines with different rhythms, modal shifts from major to minor, then back to major, the variety of percussion instruments, and the use of 16th notes all made this a very valuable educational tool. Probably our most complex tune on the piece. This is called Soaring Spirit.
Thank you.
Continuing our tradition of giving all of our faces a little bit of a break in between songs, we feature our self-selected soloists. So I gave them some suggestions of packets of tunes, things that they might recognize or know, popular tunes, Disney songs, things like that. So they all looked through it. They found something, they worked on it, came up to me and said, hey, I want to do this. So they played it, perfect rhythms, perfect notes. And I said, sure, they'll do that. So all these solos that you see throughout the evening are all hard work, mostly done by the students, with just a little bit of coaching from me. The first one we have is Louie Louie. It's performed by Luke and Elena. Seriously, I haven't been feeling very well. But the last time I wasn't feeling well, I went to the doctor, and the nurse told me, you know what, you have a fever, you need to see the doctor. Once I was with the doctor, he told me that the only prescription that he could write me was for more cowbell. Our next tune is titled More Cowbell. This is an original arrangement written by Mark Williams, inspired by a famous SNL skit featuring a rock band, a record producer, and an overzealous cowbell player. More Cowbell demonstrates the style of rock. Rock music is a broad genre of popular music that originated as rock and roll in the United States in the early 1940s and developed into a range of different styles in the 1960s and later, particularly in the United Kingdom and in the United States. It has its roots in 1940s and 1950s rock and roll, a style which drew heavily on the African-American genres of blues, rhythm and blues, and a form of country music. Rock music also drew strongly on a number of other genres, such as electric, blues, and folk, and incorporated influences from jazz, classical, and other musical styles. This is our tune called More Cowbell. Thank you. Our next soloist is going to be Finn. He's going to be playing Fereshock. She will be performing Yellow Submarine. His writing is very, very diverse, as you're going to hear, as it's as different than Soaring Spirit. So this next tune, Little Star, it's much gentler, and as you can probably guess, it is based on what we know as Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. The basic melody has always persevered, but the lyrics have had quite the revolution. It was made popularized by Mozart through his 12 variations on the melody in the 18th century. It began as the French folk song, A vous dirige maman, translating to, Ah, shall I tell you, mama? First a love poem, but then later to be parodied in a children's nursery rhyme, where the child says that sweets are worth more than reasoning. And sometimes I feel that might be true. I do like sweets. The English lyrics we know today were from a poem written in couplet form, authored by Jane Taylor, and published in 1806, but has widely been sung with other lyrics, such as the alphabet song. Demonstrating for you the connected legato style with exposed instrumentation, counter melodies, while creating balance and blend, we present to you Rob Grice's Little Star.
Thank you.
next solo is going to be John playing the Batman theme. Genre, this is going to be Chloe and Ethan playing the theme from Star Wars. By discussing how the word ogopogo is a palindrome, the native people call it naitaka, meaning lake demon. Ogopogo is written in the Phrygian mode, which is a type of minor mode. It uses quirkier orchestrations and rhythms to bring the monster to life. The enormous creature rises from the depths, plays in the waves, and then suddenly disappears back into the darkness. This is Rob Grice's Ogopogo. Actually written by Robert Buckley.
Thank you.
Our next soloist is going to be Isabel. She will be playing Linus and Lucy that we've heard from the Charlie Brown cartoons. For our last solo, for those of you who might have just celebrated or will soon be celebrating a birthday, this is going to be Happy Birthday, played by Luke and Holly, both on the saxophone. Again, all of those soloists going above and beyond what is asked of them, typical of inside our classroom. If we could give all those solos one more round of applause. Along with adding on to all sorts of thank yous, thank you to our superintendent, Dr. George Steinhoff, Mr. Eric Kamika, our assistant superintendent, all of our board of school directors, our principal here, Mrs. Sue Phillips, our general music teacher here, who's now Mrs. Denny, for all that she has done starting in first grade with me, getting good foundation for being musicians. The entire music department for being just good friends and colleagues. Anytime that I need any sort of advice, they're always there to lend me a hand. Our Pendelco Facilities Department, led here at Aston Elementary by Mr. Farmer. Again, thank you for making sure all of our chairs so we're not here standing and being really uncomfortable and then later on cleaning up everything. Our secretarial staff, for everything that they do behind the scenes. They get to hear a lot of things going on that's happening and they take care of lots of paperwork that needs to go here and there. We have a videographer here who's showcasing all of our fine work out on YouTube and other platforms like that. All of you guys, families and friends of these young musicians who are up here on the stage, without you, none of this would be available, starting with the financial aspect of getting an instrument, seeing that they're arriving at 8 o'clock practices. Without all of those things, your support at home, making sure that they're playing their instrument every waking moment that they can so that they are ready to go for those rehearsals. And just the words of encouragement that you provide them. Thank you so much for what you do for these students. And last but not least, the students themselves for, of course, putting up with me 40 minutes a week, if not twice as long for rehearsals. It's been a great 2 years. I'm certainly going to miss them as they go off to middle school, but certainly I'm going to look forward to working with them as they achieve high school status. And they're working with the marching band as I assist with them as well. Also, a couple dates to note. This Friday, I sent an email right before we started to gather here this evening. There will be a band and chorus breakfast on Friday, this Friday, May 31st. In that email was a link to a sign-up genius, so if you're able to bring something for our potluck-style breakfast, please consider signing up for something to bring. And then also at the end of June, June 24th through the 27th, there is a summer enrichment program that's going to be led by Parkside and Pennell Band director Chris Orlando. He's doing a Sounds of Summer, which is just a little band camp for any student who's going into grades 5 through 9. So they'll get a few days out of the house right after they, right after school lets out, essentially, get to work with some older kids and grow as a musician before they hopefully don't put their instrument away for the summer. Hopefully they'll continue to play throughout the summer. But if they so decide, there you go, June 24th through the 27th. Please take a look. All that information is available online, pvsd.org. Just look for the summer enrichment program packet, and everything, convenience and whatever, can be done online. So without further ado, our final tune, Cha-Cha de Salsa, written by Vincent Quesada. Cha-Cha de Salsa is an excellent piece given to our students to experience a taste of Latin American music. Latin American music is a diverse mixture of elements from African, Native American, European, and American styles. Two popular forms of Latin music are the cha-cha-cha, a dance style that was developed in Cuba in the 1950s, and the salsa, an intense dance music that was created in New York by immigrants from the Caribbean during the 1960s and the 1970s. The main characteristic of the style is its distinctive rhythmic quality. Instead of swinging the beat, Latin music uses straight eighth notes. Cha-cha de Salsa exposes our students to a new style of music, the challenges of syncopated rhythms, subito changes in dynamics, which we talked about the meaning of subito, meaning suddenly, and features of soli sections all throughout the piece. Thanks for coming. Our final piece, Cha-Cha de Salsa.